Hello my dear students, we have been studying about the coagulation or precipitation of the colloids. We mostly study right now about the lyophobic salts. So first we have studied the two method, now we have the third method. Third method is by boiling. When a salt is boiled, the adsorbed layer is disturbed due to the increased collision with the molecules of dispersion medium. This reduces the charges on the particles and ultimately lead to settling down in the form of a precipitate. So this is how by boiling even we increases the collision and thus the precipitates are formed and we can have the coagulation or precipitation of colloid. By persistent dialysis, you know that dialysis is the process of removing the electrolyte to the requisite minimum, but if more dialysis is done, the requisite minimum amount of electrolyte can also be decreased, and thus this is what it causes the coagulation or precipitation. On prolonged dialysis, traces of the electrolyte present in the salt are removed almost completely and the colloid become unstable and ultimately coagulate. By addition of electrolytes, when excess of an electrolyte is added, the colloidal particles are precipitated. The reason is that colloid interact with ions carrying the charge opposite to that present on themselves. So oppositely charged colloid, they are mixed, they causes the coagulation. This causes neutralization leading to their coagulation. The ion responsible for neutralization of charge on the particle is called coagulating ion. So this is what it is, the definition of your coagulating ion. Please learn it well. A negative ion causes the precipitation of positively charged salt, and a positive ion causes the precipitation of negatively charged salt. Now we should understand the flocculating ion. So the ion responsible for neutralization of charge on the particle is called flocculating ion. Then we have the Hardy and Schultz rule. It has been observed, this Hardy and Schultz have, they have observed this. So they, it has been observed generally that the greater is the valency of the flocculating ion added, the greater is the power to cause precipitation. Greater is the valency means more is the charge. Suppose the charge is plus 1, then it is, and plus 2, then plus 2 will have better ability to coagulate. The coagulation of negative salt, the flocculating power of Na plus, Ba plus and Al plus 3 are in the order. Al plus 3 is greater than Ba plus 2 is greater than Na plus 1, because as the charges are less or the valencies are less, the less is the ability to coagulate. Similarly, in the coagulation of a positive salt, the flocculating power of Cl minus, SO4 minus 2 and PO4 minus 3 and FeCn6 minus 4 is in the order. FeCn6 is having highest, then PO4 minus 3, then SO4 minus 2 and then Cl minus. Then we have the new term, that is what it is known as the coagulating value or flocculation value. The minimum concentration of an electrolyte in millimole per liter required to cause precipitation of a salt in 2 hours is called the flocculating value. Please remember these words here, millimole. Millimole means 10 to the power minus 1 mole per liter. That is, you know, we need to add this millimole into 1 liter of that particular solution, and the precipitation must be done within 2 hours. So this is what it is needed, or it is also called the coagulating value. The smaller the flocculating value, higher would be the coagulating power. So we can say that coagulating flocculating value proportional to 1 upon coagulating power. Flocculation value is inversely proportional to the coagulating power. This is what we can easily understand. Coagulating value, this is the definition for coagulating value. the smaller, or we can see we'll study about the points of coagulating value. The smaller the coagulating value, the smaller the quantity needed for electrolyte, the higher will be the coagulating power of an anion. So again, coagulating value is inversely proportional to the coagulating power. The coagulation value in millimole per liter electrolyte used for coagulation of As2S3 are, for NaCl it is 52 millimole per liter, KCl it is 51, BaCl2 it is 0.69, and MgSO4 it is 0.22. The order of their flocculating power can be written as MgSO4 is greater than BaCl2 is greater than KCl is greater than NaCl. As flocculating value or coagulating value are 0.22 is greater than 0.69 is greater than 51 is greater than 52 millimoles per liter. So this is how we can understand. What modification can you suggest in the Hardy-Schulz law? Hardy and Schulz law suggest us that more is the valency of iron, more will be its flocculating or coagulation power. Now what we can suggest, let us try to understand that. So flocculation or coagulating power is in the order of m plus 3 is greater than m plus 2 or is greater than m plus 1, or m minus 3 is greater than m minus 2 is greater than m minus 1 for negative and positively charged colloids respectively. But what if two ions have same charges? In this case, flocculating power or coagulating power depends upon the polarizing power. Now, so we can write flocculating power or coagulating power proportional to polarizing power. A polarizing power depends upon the charge is to size ratio, or we can say that the charge density. So we can say polarizing power proportional to charge divided by size of an ion. Polarizing power proportional to charge density. For same charge, smaller is the size, more is the coagulating power. So as the size of an ion decreases, more will be its polarizing power. For negatively charged As2S3 salt, the polarizing power of Mg plus 2 is greater than Ba plus 2, because the size of Mg is smaller than the size of Ba in the same group. Coagulation value of MgSO4 is 0.22, whereas BSO4 is 0.69 millimoles per liter. So this is how we can understand. Same way for element belong to S block or D block with same charges, generally polarizing power of D block element is more as compared to the polarizing power of S block element. So we can say that Cu plus 1 will have more polarizing power than Na plus 1. This is due to the pseudo inert gas configuration, you know, which is also can be represented as NS2NP6N-1D10 of Cu. The electronic configuration of Cu plus 1, it should be Cu plus 1. This is what I should write here, Cu plus 1, is 4S2 3D10, which is actually, you know, pseudo, like not exactly the inert gas, but it looks like inert gas because all the orbitals are completely filled, and that is why we call it pseudo first order, pseudo inert gas, because inert gas will have NS2NP6 completely filled. While Na plus has inert gas electronic configuration, as Na plus will have helium 3s2 3p6, and that is why the coagulating power of pseudo inert gas will be more as compared to the inert gas configuration. For anion, even the same smaller the size, charge is to size ratio, more will be its coagulating power. Let us understand the same with some examples. We'll study in the next video. Happy learning.